So these are a type of polymers comes under condensation polymer category. So let us have how this nylon 6,6 produced from condensation polymerization reaction or polymerization reaction. Here the two monomers required for the preparation of nylon 6,6 are hexamethylene diamine. So this is one monomer, reacts with C double bond O OH CH2 taken 4 C double bond O OH. What is this? This is hexamethylene diamine as one monomer. And another monomer used in the same reaction to produce nylon 6,6 are adipic acid. So what is adipic acid? 6 carbon to dicarboxylic acid is called as adipic acid. 1 plus 4, 5 plus 1, totally 6 carbons are present here. Just identify, as per our previous statement, first statement under condensation polymers, those monomers which wants to produce condensation polymers are bifunctionalized or trifunctionalized chemical species. Here just observe here, hexamethylene diamine with two amine functional groups, adipic acid with two acid functional groups. What is the expectation? Here hydrogen from one amine of hexamethyl diamine and OH group of one acids, adipic acids, one carbon eliminated out. That means loss of water molecule expected during the reaction. As per this statement, when the two different monomers or same monomers reacts with each other under this category, there is a loss of a neutral species like water, H2S, ammonia, HCl, etc. takes place and produces NH CH2 taken 6 NH. This is the most important. The nitrogen of hexamethylene diamine is going to make bond with C double bond O carbon of adipic acid and remaining are same CH2 taken 4 C double bond O. So it continuously takes place. That means N number of hexamethylene diamines when reacts with N number of adipic acids, continuously the chain formation continuously takes place. The resulting polymer is comes under condensation polymer. This is nothing but nylon 6,6. Why we have to use 6,6 for nylon here is the two different monomers used by us for the formation of this polymer. How many carbon atoms are present in hexamethylene diamine? 6 carbons. Then we have to use first 6 here. And how many carbon atoms are present in adipic acid? 1 plus 4. 5 plus 1. 6. So one more 6 we have to use here. Nylon 6,6. That means the two different polymers which produces nylon in this category are having 6 carbons and 6 carbons. To show this, we have to use 6,6 as suffix word after nylon, so hence it is called as nylon 6,6. So this is condensation polymers. Once again, this is the most important classification, especially in case of synthesis of polymers. So classification of polymers based on mode of polymerization. How many modes are identified during the polymerization are two types. They are addition polymerization and condensation polymerization. Once again, the polymers resulting from addition polymerization are called as addition polymers. These are again two types, homopolymers and copolymers. What are homopolymers? Those addition polymers resulting from the addition reaction of similar type of monomers are called as homopolymers. Similarly, example is polyethylene. And what are copolymers? The polymers, addition polymers, which results from two or more different polymers or monomers are called as copolymers. Example is the just explained butadiene. Whereas the second category, condensation polymers, So those polymers which resulting from condensation of two or more similar or different types of monomers are called as condensation polymers. Generally, those monomers which are having bifunctionalized or two functional groups or three functional groups only produces condensation polymers. So during the condensation, there may be loss of neutral species like water, H2S, ammonia, HCl, etc. takes place. Examples for these condensation polymers are nylon 6,6 or nylon 6. So we can show the general reaction that takes place during the formation of nylon 6,6 from n moles of hexamethyl diamine with n moles of adipic acid. So this is one more type of classification, that is classification based on mode of condensation.